All right. Good afternoon, everybody. Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Hello. All right. Thank you, guys. Wow. If you build it, they will come. Look at this crowd. This is fantastic. Thank you all so much for coming out to our second performance of Annie here at Wilbur Charter. My name is Jay Winnick. I'm the director and producer of today's performance. First of all, to all of my friends who are sitting in the front, we are going to be really good audience members. We're going to be quiet. We're not going to rustle papers. We're not going to scream and yell at our friends. But what we are going to do is laugh if it's funny, cry if it's sad. Right? There's nothing sad, so you don't have to worry about that. All right, applaud when at the end of the song. But just be a good audience member. You guys would all put your cell phones away. Also, we are going back to 1933. Right around the time that I was born. Just ask the kids. 1933, they did not have cell phones, so please, if you guys could all turn your cell phones off, we would put them on silent, we would appreciate it. We also do have wireless microphones. Guys, we do have wireless microphones, so they do interfere with them. So if we could keep the cell phones on silent or off, that would be fantastic. Any of you saw the show yesterday? The reviews have come out in the LA Times, Deadline, all those papers. We're a big hit. We're going on the road next summer. You guys were like, yeah. But what we are doing next summer, what a great segue, is we have a wonderful camp. It's our fourth year at Portola, right across the street. We're very excited about our summer musical theater workshop. It's a four-week camp. In the morning, the kids from 9 to 12 will go to different acting, singing, and dance workshops. And then in the afternoon, they all come together for the entire camp to rehearse. The show we're doing this year is Wizard of Oz Jr. So we're very excited about the Wizard of Oz this summer. Please, the information's on the back of your playbill, or please contact me, Farnaz, anybody involved with this production. We're all involved with the summer program as well. Also, many of you received an email from me last night. We are doing another show here at Wilbur, starting in 2 weeks, February 5th. And the show we are doing is Aladdin Jr. So please sign up as soon as possible so we can get that one going also. We love working here at Wilbur. We are so appreciative and thankful to Dr. Shirley. When you see her, please say thank you. Thank you for supporting the arts in our public schools. We appreciate it. One last thing. We are so grateful that we get to have, and it's rare in most young people's performances, to have live piano music. And to have live piano music, it allows the kids to really learn how to sing properly and also how to sing in the correct key, because their voices are already changing. Like, they changed in the last 5 minutes. So we're able to have somebody as amazing as Bob Repstein on the piano. Thank you, Bob. Extraordinaire. So we are appreciative to have Bob here. Thank you so much. Everybody, remember, turn your cell phones off. Please be as quiet as we can. If you have a little one that does start to yell or scream and gets out of hand, please take them to the back and outside. These guys have worked very hard. Most of these children, the first time they have ever been on stage or in front of an audience was yesterday afternoon. And they were fantastic. We are so proud of them. They worked very hard. So please enjoy Annie Jr.
take good care of our little darling. Her name is Anne.
She was born on October 28th. We'll be back to get her soon.
We have left half of a silver locket around her neck and kept the other half.
So that when we come back for her, we will know that she's our baby.
Oh my goodness, now we're all laughing.
Oh, right. Do you want to sleep with your teeth inside your mouth or out?
Gee, I'm dreaming about having a mother and father again, but you're lucky. You really got them.
I know somewhere.
Now for this one, shenanigans, you'll get down on your knobby
after you, ain't they? Well, they're after me too.
But don't you worry. I ain't gonna let them get you or me. I think it's gonna be fine for the both of us. If not today, well...
Thank you. Well, are you glad to be back? Huh?
Yes, Miss Hannigan.
Liar! What's the one thing I always taught you? Never tell a lie.
Good afternoon, Miss Hannigan.
Yes.
I'm Grace Farrell, private secretary to Oliver Warbucks.
The
Oliver Warbucks?
The millionaire?
Mr. Warbucks has decided to invite orphans for the Christmas holidays at his home.
What sort of orphan did he have in mind?
What about this child right here?
Annie? Oh, no, no, you don't want her.
Annie, would you like to spend the next 2 weeks at Mr. Warbucks' home?
I would love to!
If you get her coat, I'll take her along right now.
Well, she don't have no coat.
Then we'll buy her one. Merry Christmas. Come along, Annie.
Oops. Pardon me. Hey, you sis. Long time no see. This is Lily.
Rooster, they finally let you out of prison.
Who was the blondie I bumped into on the way in?
Oh, she works for Oliver Warbucks.
The Oliver Warbucks.
Annie, one of the orphans, is gonna go live with him.
Crummy orphans.
Yeah, live in the lap of luxury of two Hannigan kids end up on the skids. It ain't fair how we scrounge for $3 or $4 while she gets Warbucks.
The little brats. It ain't fair, this your life is driving me nuts. While we get peanuts, she's living fat.
Maybe she holds the key, that little lady,
to getting more bucks
instead of less. Maybe we fix the game with something shady. Where does that put us? Give me one guess. Bye.
man-to-man talk?
You send me back to the orphanage, right?
No, of course not. I've realized something. No matter how much money you've got, if you have no one to share your life with, then you might as well be broke. Here.
Wow, for me, Miss Orbex?
Thank you. It's a silver locket, Annie. I noticed that old, broken one you always used to wear. Annie, what is it?
This locket. My mother and father left it when they left me at the orphanage. I know I'm real lucky being here with you for Christmas, but the one thing I want in all the world is to find my mother and father and be like other kids.
It will be all right. I'll find them. I'll find your parents for you. We'll put up a national search on the radio.
Thank you, Miss Warbucks. Thank you.
Not who he says he is.
Then I won't give up till we are certain. But how? I'll go straight to the top.
Merry Christmas, Miss Warbucks. Miss Farrell, you're up early.
We've been up all night, dear. FBI and President Roosevelt are here.
Leaping lizards! Really?
Annie, early this morning, FBI Director Hoover of the identity of your parents, and they were not the Mudges. He knew they were David and Margaret Bennett, and they passed away a long time ago.
You mean I'm an orphan after all?
Annie, are you all right?
Yes, because I know they love me. I would have come back for me if they could. But now, who the heck are Ralph and Shirley Mudge?
No one knew about the locket except us.
And Miss Hannigan.
And Miss Hannigan!
Sir, Miss Hannigan and the kids from the orphanage.
Annie!
I'm delighted to meet you.
Same here. I'd know you anywhere.
Sir, Mr. and Miss Mudge.
Hello. We just came to pick up Annie. And the chick.
Here it is, Mr. Mudge. $50,000.
Certified and paid to the order of...
The chick is up!
That's right, Daniel Francis Hannigan, also known as...
Brewster Hannigan, also known as Ralph Mudge.
And I believe you'll find here that this woman is their accomplice.
Annie, you know how nice and kind I was to you?
Gee, I'm sorry, Miss Hannigan, but remember the one thing you've always taught me. Never tell a lie. Miss Hannigan is gone for good!
The sun.
performing, supporting the arts here at Wilbur. We so appreciate. We'll give you a few minutes to take some pictures with your kids. Not